Greece is one of the main entry gates into Europe.
We don't even have basic needs. Sometimes we stayed all day without eating food.
You see, basically to the park.
They seek safety in Europe, but Greece is not safe.
You come in Greece, you will know Greece.
I see frightened people, a lot of frightened people.
Sometimes if you go outside, they try to beat us.
There is a very worrying increase in racist violence, and we hear about attacks almost daily.
Directly on their hearts, knives on their hearts.
I like Greece, but Greece don't like foreigners. Greece don't like foreigners, especially black people, they hate foreigners.
Most refugees arrive in Europe by foot or by boat, landing in Greece, Italy, and Spain. Under EU regulation, asylum claims have to be made in the country through which refugees first enter Europe. They cannot move to another European country. In 2011, the European Court of Human Rights found that asylum seekers in Greece are at risk of inhuman and degrading treatment.
First of all, it was done for the deficiencies in the asylum procedure to the detention conditions and living conditions in Greece.
Not even the police or the state gives us an exact number of refugees. It's complicated, we don't know the number, the exact.
In 2010, it was estimated by Frontex that about 80% of all those who entered the European Union entered through Greece. So all those people had nowhere to stay, no social welfare, and many of them were just sleeping rough, and they were trapped in Greece with no possibility to leave and no possibility to stay.
On demand, in aid, apropos de l'Union européenne, ça ne va pas du tout. Ça ne va pas. Il y a d'autres qui dorment dans les patias et mangent dans les poubelles.
We are not eating good food. We go in school without hungry.
16-year-old Barry lives in a hostel for child refugees, some as young as 8. These images of the conditions inside were filmed by one of the residents.
You can see the toilet the way it is.
17-year-old Yazin is a resident in the same hostel.
I have big problem. Don't have work, don't have money, don't have clothes, don't have shoes.
A few months later, Yazin receives bad news about his family back in Pakistan.
Last month, they bombed our home, lost my family.
The same summer, Yazin turns 18 and is made to leave the hostel. Since then, he has been on the streets. Early in the morning, Athens parks are full of refugees sleeping rough. When they are picked up by the police after crossing the border, they are initially detained and then left to fend for themselves.
Police tell me, go outside. You see, I sleep to the park.
They tell me, go, okay, go. I have nowhere to go. I don't know nobody.
Sleep in the park. Sometimes you pick something from the refuge bin to eat. No house, nothing I can do.
Vraiment, en Grèce ici, on souffre beaucoup. On souffre. On souffre beaucoup, car vraiment, on a des difficultés même ici, même de se nourrir, payer l'eau, manger. C'est dur pour nous.
People, they have to help refugees in this country. they don't have arrangement for refugees. But we leave our country for problem. We don't leave our country as we like. Nobody likes to leave his country for his heart. We leave because of the problem.
They give me a gun, you know, AK-47, they say you have to fight.
Nordin did not want to fight. His mother sent him out of the country so he would be safe. From Syria, he walked for weeks, traveling through Turkey on foot to get to Europe.
I'm staying in Ahenon, that's on the street. I'm staying with my friends.
Ahenon is a neighborhood in Athens with a large Somali community.
Welcome to Somalia. No Greek, Somalia.
Peace.
Yeah, this is the place. This is the house I'm living.
I sleep here, you see. But this is mine, I sleep here. There's other seven guys that sleep here. Not everybody has one. We share, you know, we share the meal.
18 people share this tiny one-bedroom flat.
We really need help from the European countries. You know, we want to really get out of this country. We have really problem here.
Yeah, I have eye problem in this eye, as you can see. I tried to go to hospital 3 times. They didn't help me nothing.
Nordin managed to get a referral and prescription for his eye condition after visiting the free clinic run by Doctors of the World.
We started off by taking care only migrants and refugees patients. It's only the last 6 months when the economic crisis started that we see a lot of Greek patients as well. At least the last year we have a humanitarian crisis because of the economic crisis.
Since there's no money, yeah, I understand, yeah, there's bad economic. You people should allow us to live.
C'est trop dur, quoi. En tout cas, je cherche l'opportunité de quitter la Grèce. En tout cas, que ce soit dans les pays européens, quoi.
And we see even asylum seekers now that they want to go back to their countries because they have no jobs, they cannot survive in Greece.
I'm maybe come back my country because here is not good for me. My country is better.
Really?
Yes, yes.
Mahmoud has spent time in an Iranian prison.
Here is a situation where you feel that there is dire need for European solidarity and active solidarity.
Because usually immigrants come here and they don't have legal papers because they want to go to other European countries.
If you want to go to other country, France, Norway, airport problem. When we end up in a country very poor, you people should allow us to go.
Of course.
Why? In airports, figure. Always. Why?
The other member states want Greece to control the border so that the people don't go irregularly there.
We are trapped in like a prison. It's a prison.
I go to the airport, I told them this paper, they write I have to leave the country within 30 days, so I'm leaving, I'm going to other country. I was arrested 3 days in jail.
There are many people and many asylum seekers that do not manage to apply for asylum and may be in the streets of Athens undocumented.
Ça, il voit ça. Il y a plein de migrants qui sont là, personne n'a pas pris.
The police station in Athens, where most refugees make their initial asylum claim, is Petrourali. Applications can be made once a week.
I'm coming there 2 months every week I'm there.
Here. And how long have you been here?
6 months.
2 years. Every week coming. No good paper.
Yeah, les gens qui sont là 3 ans, 10 ans, on donne pas partout.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Day, night,
all. Day, night. You see, the sun, the cold, no house, nowhere to sleep, no water, no food, no toilets.
Not only do asylum seekers queue day and night, sometimes waiting for months or even years to start their application, they also say the police forcibly disperse them, preventing them from registering their asylum claims.
Before you go came, there was pushing us like as a slave trade.
La police vient, on nous chasse, on s'en va. Après, on vient, ça va, on nous chasse.
Police, beat.
Beat, yeah, police.
Beat people. They say we should go.
People will stay here for quite long. Yeah. They cannot pursue us again.
An interpreter was willing to speak about her experiences working at this police station on condition of anonymity. Her words are spoken by an actress.
I think one of the main problems with Petrourali is the back gate. In theory, your interview should take place from 3 up to 6 months after you applied for the asylum. Most of the cases it's not like that. It could be like 2 years before you have your first interview. So they have to come and renew their PIN card every 3 to 6 months. So they come at 6 o'clock in the morning, they wait outside behind the grills. Even if it's raining, if it's snowing, if it's 40 degrees, they have to wait there. So at 2:30 or 3, a cop or two come back and they call names without keeping any confidentiality at all.
Bilami, Afghanistan, Bilami. Allah Matula.
So they're given their PIN cards, but sometimes they also give rejections or positive, mostly rejections, because I've never heard of any positive decision actually. So they call names, they will bring in and out about 10 or 20 people. The point is they will not translate the whole decision, they will just tell them, you leave the country, you fuck off, or you're done with asylum, or you didn't convince anyone with your lies.
In these situations, extremist groups take advantage. They find fertile ground to take advantage.
The racist people, their community, which is called racist people, they don't like black people. They break the windows, you see.
Showing the stone inside the house, and you're sleeping inside. They were staying here like 10 minutes, and with the police also here. They don't do nothing, you see. There are more than 50 people chanting,
go back, we can't do black people, something like that.
They stabbed one boy from here to here. The boy wanted to die. When I saw the boy yesterday, the boy started telling me that Christy Afgi wanted to kill him. Because they don't want foreigners. They call themselves Nazi group.
Christy Afgi, or Golden Dawn, is an extreme right party. In the 2012 elections, they won 18 out of 300 seats in the Greek parliament, with 7% of the vote. Mobile phone footage, published online, shows Golden Dawn supporters singing their anthem and giving Nazi salutes.
Like a neo-Nazi party, a Nazi sympathizing party, in a territory, in a part of the world where the Nazis caused huge pain only a few decades ago, it doesn't logically make any sense. It can't really exist.
Έχω καταγράψουμε στοιχεία από την Εθνική Στατιστική Υπηρεσία πόσος ήταν ο πληθυσμός της Ελλάδας όταν ξεκίνησε ο πόλεμος. Ο πληθυσμός ήταν 7.344.000. Όταν τελείωσε ο πόλεμος, ο πληθυσμός μας ήταν 6.344.000.
Manolis Glezos, who is a Syriza MP, has a seat in Parliament, and he, with his friend in 1941, climbed to the Acropolis and pulled down the swastika and put up the Greek flag. And he has to sit in the Parliament with neo-Nazis in this extraordinary situation.
Golondone is an originally fascist organization. It has connections with all the fascist parties in the whole Europe and the whole world, even Ku Klux Klan.
Opinion polls at the end of 2012 show growing support for Golden Dawn, placing them third. The following mobile phone clip was filmed at a Golden Dawn meeting in Perama, on the outskirts of Athens. The day after that meeting, Egyptians are gathered in Perama at the home of some fishermen.
المصريين هنا عمرهم ما كانوا متحدين اطلاقا من الشعب اليوناني بالعكس كان في علاقه وطيده وعلاقه طيبه جدا بين الشعب المصري وبين الشعب اليوناني وبين الجاليه اليونانيه وبين الجاليه المصريه لكن في الاونه الاخيره بدا يظهر حزب الخريسيه في ايديس اللي هو اليمين المتطرف باعدائه للاجانب
العربيه دي اللي احنا بنشتغلوا بيها الساعة احنا كنا نايمين انا واخواتي الساعة 3 بالليل في بيتنا نايمين امنين في بيتنا هنا وبنبص تلاقينا الساعة 3:10 تلاقينا الباب والشباك بيتكسر علينا يعني مش خبطة تكسير فانا بفتح الباب بفتح الشباك بشوف ده مين ده تلاقيت اكتر من 10-15 واحد اللي هم النجم الذهبي اللي هم كاتبين عليهم الخريسيه فيه باليوناني يعني اللي هو النجم الذهبي بالعربي كل واحد كان معاه اقل واحد كان معاه حديده زي ديت يعني انا الصبح بعد هم ماشي بعد انا ما جيت من البوليس بس لقيت يعني كانوا سايبين دي وراهم ناسين ديت اقل واحد كان معاه حديده زي ديت يعني لو خبطت باي بسجره مش راجل حديده زي بسجره هتقطع السجره واحنا مش عارفين بيعملوا كده كمصريين معانا ليه انا راجل هنا بقالي 20 سنه بدفع ضرايبي بدفع كل حاجه وعندي محل
هم جم من هنا تقريبا من الشارع ده وهم نازلين اكتشفوا ان في واحد من الصيادين المصريين كان نايم هنا
كلها وساب فلوس وساب سجاير ومفتاح
بعد كده تلاقينا اللي فوق على السطاح بند علينا الحقونا الحقوني الحقوني رحت فوق اشوف الراجل اللي معانا كان فوق يعني كانت الدنيا حر وهو قاعد فوق ساعتين ثلاثه فخدوا النوم فوق هنا على السطاح رحنا نجيبوه لقينا وشه ده كله ما فيش وش دم بس كل ده دم بيتسقط كله دم مالوش وش بس انا مش عارف يعني هم بيعملوا احنا معانا طب دي حاجه ضد الانسانيه ومش عارفينها يعني لاخرتها مع الناس دي ايه
This is very sad, unbelievable. Around about 700 to 800 attacks and many attacks to kill the peoples.
And there is a kind of pattern in these attacks. Many people going together, attacking one migrant, using dogs to intimidate them.
They start telling the dog like to chase us. Take him. And they were laughing, they were happy.
That they go to the areas where the immigrants live and they wait for them, especially late at night. And then like 3 or 4 or 5 of them attack one.
There were many, they grab me, start beating me.
So it, in a sense, yeah, it's not random. I think, yeah, it must be organized in that sense.
Some days were very heavy for us. There was around about in one day 31 people was in hospital. They are injured, broken legs and hands and open heads.
I have seen personally people that have been beaten in the face, in the head, and they were afraid actually to come immediately. They were beaten like on a Saturday, and they would come like in the midweek, next week, because they were afraid to circulate in the town.
Hey, Mavre, that's hey, Brock. Hey, block.
How do I know that it is the Golden Dawn? I just ask them who hit you. They say white people wearing black clothes with the signs.
The people who chase immigrants, if they see them on the road, and they have always something, a sign of Golden Dawn.
And if you hear their spots on TV, they threaten Greek people who might be helping in every, even speaking with an immigrant. They threaten them as well.
Our dead brother's name was Shehzad Lukman. He was living in Peristeri from last 4 years.
He was going to his job with a bike.
They were waiting there, and when he was there, they put out their knives, their weapons. They killed that our brother.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Perpetrators of racist attacks are rarely apprehended. However, on this occasion, it was different.
The taxi driver saw the whole thing and he called the police.
Every minute he was making phone, he's now here, he's now turning from the spot of the murder till the Sidharma. He was around about 35, 40 minutes he was behind. At last, in Sidharma, they arrested. And there was the knife with the blood they find from them.
In the home of one of the suspects, the police also found a selection of weapons and Golden Dawn literature.
And now the police does not accept that it was an attack by racist and nationalist motivations.
The law never arrests them. This was the efforts of one taxi driver, very brave man, and we salute, I especially salute that person.
Every day in broad daylight, there's attacks, say, on buses or in the streets, where Greek citizens intervene and call the police when there's an attack on an immigrant, and police have showed up and they have arrested the immigrants, and sometimes they even harass and arrest the Greek people.
Everywhere where an attack is happening, there's always a car or a cycle or a policeman walking like they didn't see anything.
One attack, even the police was near there, they did nothing. They were talking, they act like they don't see me.
I have a friend, a black one, who works with me. And suddenly a car stopped and four people come out from the car. They attacked him and the police was there. He was calling the police and they are looking, they don't move. And they leave the cars go. And after they say, no, we cannot do anything for you.
There is no accountability from the police, and there's no accountability from the Greek state.
From police, from government, they have open permit.
But what you have here is a state that has a clear continuity with a totalitarian regime. We have to remember that Greece had a dictatorship that, yes, it did end in 1974 officially, but there was a transition and not a rupture into the post-dictatorial state, into the democratic state.
When the junta fell in 1974, the police force was never really cleaned up, and so the police force in Greece doesn't really operate to serve and protect the people in a way that it should in a democratic society.
I've been beaten by fascists several times.
I've beaten by police more times than I've beaten by fascists since 1973 and the revolt against the dictatorship. It was about 11 o'clock in the morning. Then we heard some voices outside, and we found out that there was one policeman in plain clothes and one in uniform beating an immigrant. We started shouting from the windows, things like stop these racist attacks. In a second, there were about 30 policemen, 25 to 30 policemen, riot police, coming from the one side of the road, and about 15 other people from the other side of the road. Later we discovered that they were members of the Golden Dawn. They took the immigrant away, and they all gathered outside in the front door of our offices, starting shouting on us at the beginning, saying that you have to come down and you give protection to illegal immigrants and we're going to arrest you. Then the other one shouting, we won't just arrest you, we will, okay, fuck you.
Really?
Some of them were saying you will turn you to soap, you know, the fascist Nazi slogan. It was terrifying thing. Just because there were the fascists there, but because together with the fascists were policemen in uniforms, officially showing that they were policemen, being in a kind of, how to say, delirium, crazy, real, beating, shouting, swearing.
They ask me, where is your paper? When I give them my paper, they ask me, is this the paper?
They cut it, and then they put it like this. They say, this is not a paper.
I say, you are the one who gave me the paper. They attack me, the police, and then they remove my shirts. I stay without no shirts. They lock me. They say, take him in the police. He don't have paper. They take me to the police. I have paper. After 9 hours, they leave me.
So we have also testimonies of people that have been attacked by the police.
The police beat you like animals. They beat you like animals.
We have people that come, they have been hit by globs by the police.
Ammonia is an Athens neighborhood with a large migrant community.
I was walking through Ammonia and I heard a lot of screaming and shouting, and I saw an immigrant being arrested by two policemen with their scarves over their face, and he fell to the ground and they picked him up by his legs. He was in handcuffs and they started dragging him along the ground. I took my mobile phone out and started filming, at which point they turned their attention on me and surrounded me, and an argument followed demanding my phone, and I was arrested and taken to the police station for the day.
Police have a permanent presence, checking papers and arresting people. At a street corner in Ammonia, police are detaining foreigners suspected of being in the country illegally. The detainees wave at the camera, motioning to get closer. But the police object to the recording of their actions.
Η αστυνομία δεν έχει κανένα δικαίωμα να σου απαγορεύσει να τραβήξεις βίντεο, να φωτογραφίσεις σε δημόσιο χώρο.
Sorry. We've been stopped.
Και δύο πράσινα από εδώ.
I'm sorry.
Και δύο από εδώ. Here.
I don't understand. We don't understand.
Are you journalists?
Yeah, we're journalists, yes, we're from London.
It is illegal recording
police. Identification, okay. Yeah?
Δεν μπορούν με τίποτε να πάρουν φωτογραφικό υλικό από την κάρτα σου ή από το βίντεο σου. Απαγορεύεται ρητά.
If take video, delete.
Δεν μπορούν με τίποτε να πάρουν, να αγγίξουν φωτογραφική σου μηχανή τη βιντεοκάμερα.
And it's been a very serious development a few months ago where a group of demonstrators, including women, were arrested and held in detention and tortured. They went on motorbikes through some of the areas in Athens that have high immigrant populations where Golden Dawn have been literally terrorizing people to show that we Greek citizens or we Greek people are in solidarity with immigrants and we don't accept that our neighborhoods are being taken over and dominated by neo-Nazis.
They were hitting them, they were slapping them, they were spitting them, they were using them as ashtrays. When I went there and saw them, I was shocked by what I saw about the beating. The heavy bruises are not inflicted by one hit. These are repeatedly hits with different instruments and means in the same body parts, and that can happen only if you intend to do to inflict severe pain on someone, if you want to torture him. What we heard from the 15 arrested people is that the policemen who were doing all these things to them openly claimed that they are members of the Golden Dawn. What was transferred to me is that the most terrifying thing of all was that other policemen was filming on their cell phones, on the mobile phones, saying that they will use these videos and photographs to give them to Golden Dawn. The official line of the police is that nothing like that happened.
What has happened now in my reading is that the Golden State, the Golden Dawn, sorry, has come in as a kind of a backup, one of the last few backups the state has to impose fear on its citizens, on its subjects, and to continue kind of existing and ruling as before.
Fear is not an option. All the people should understand that. We must not fear them. If we let them fear us and terrorize us, then they win. This must not happen. People should fight back. People should resist. People have the power to do so.
In June 2012, 97-year-old Katina Sifakaki leads a march against Golden Dawn through Athens. She has fought fascism once before, during the Second World War, when she was part of the Greek resistance.
Ο λαός ήταν ενωμένος, επαραμέρισαν κάθε διαφορά που ήταν μεταξύ τους.
In April 2012, a few hundred people joined a protest against Golden Dawn. Since then, thousands have taken to the streets to protest against racist attacks in solidarity with refugees and migrants.
These groups, anti-fascist, the left wings, are hope for the immigrants.
There's been a very, very strong and diverse response, which you don't see reported in the international media, on the really local level in neighborhoods and squares all over Greece.
We're going to come together and protest against these deranged, murderous fascists. We are not afraid of them. Greece's society is a freedom-loving, democratic spontaneous society.
There's no money left to run even the most basics of services. You know, you don't have any money to run hospitals properly or kindergartens or anything. Like even the most kind of primary, the most basic kind of infrastructures for people's everyday lives are not there anymore.
Greek doctors have been instructed in a directive to not treat undocumented migrants.
I used to work in a hospital about a year ago, and we had that instruction, but we never followed it. Because as doctors, we have sworn to help people. We use a mobile clinic, and they were treating people near a Golden Dawn office, and they were out on the balcony, and they were showing, like, we will get you to us, that we are doctors.
In a lot of international media, the Golden Dawn is portrayed as somewhat anti-systemic, maybe, as a party trying to create some sort of rupture, some sort of, you know, radical change, while essentially they are the continuation of mainstream politics by other means.
Before the last elections, you saw speeches, for instance, by Samaras, even going as far as saying we need to clean Greece of immigrants, the kind of terms that sort of points to ethnic cleansing, which is exactly the sort of language that Golden Dawn used.
When Samaras was saying, for example, we have to clean the streets from immigrants, Golden Dawn was getting out and starting hitting immigrants in the streets.
The Prime Minister's choice of words, to clean the streets, draws a direct parallel between migrants and dirt or litter. Speaking of migrants in terms of disease, natural disaster or infestation bears the implicit message they are a threat to society.
People are moving, they are desperate, they're because of violations of human rights, because of poverty, because of climate change. For all these reasons, people are moving.
Because I get in the country and they give me the paper for 30 days, you should leave the country. I don't know where to go now for the 30 days. I should leave the country, go back to Somalia.
We've had like 10 people coming from Iran, Afghanistan or Iraq in 2000, and now we have thousands of them. It's not something that happened by accident. We didn't leave them any choice back in their country, so they came here.
Most of them did not really want to come to Greece.
I really want to be in any country which is better than this.
We are not animals, we are human beings. We can walk, we can eat, we can talk. So please, I'm begging two of you now, anybody that will see us on here, tell them, we please them, they should allow us to go. Please. Greece is one of the main entry gates into Europe.
We don't even have basic needs. Sometimes we stayed all day without eating food.
You see, hastily to depart.
They seek safety in Europe, but Greece is not safe.
You come in Greece, you will know Greece.
pas de travail, sans papiers, la police, pour le problème.
I see frightened people, a lot of frightened people.
Sometimes if you go outside, they try to beat us.
There is a very worrying increase in racist violence, and we hear about attacks almost daily.
Directly on their hearts, knives on their hearts.
I like Greece, but Greece don't like foreigners. Greece don't like foreigners, especially black people, they hate foreigners.
Most refugees arrive in Europe by foot or by boat, landing in Greece, Italy, and Spain. Under EU regulation, asylum claims have to be made in the country through which refugees first enter Europe. They cannot move to another European country. In 2011, the European Court of Human Rights found that asylum seekers in Greece are at risk of inhuman and degrading treatment.
First of all, it was done for the deficiencies in the asylum procedure to the detention conditions and living conditions in Greece.
None of even the police or the state gives us an exact number of refugees. It's complicated. We don't know the number, the exact.
In 2010, it was estimated by Frontex that about 80% of all those who entered the European Union entered through Greece. So all those people had nowhere to stay, no social welfare, and many of them were just sleeping rough, and they were trapped in Greece with no possibility to leave and no possibility to stay.
On demand in aid apropos de l'Union européenne, ça ne va pas du tout.
We are not eating good food. We go in school with hungry.
16-year-old Barry lives in a hostel for child refugees, some as young as 8. These images of the conditions inside were filmed by one of the residents.
You can see the toilet the way it is.
17-year-old Yazin is a resident in the same hostel.
I have big problem. Don't have work, don't have money, don't have clothes, don't have shoes.
A few months later, Yazin receives bad news about his family back in Pakistan.
Last month, they bombed our home, lost my family.
The same summer, Yazin turns 18 and is made to leave the hostel. Since then, he has been on the streets. Early in the morning, Athens parks are full of refugees sleeping rough. When they are picked up by the police after crossing the border, they are initially detained and then left to fend for themselves.
Police tell me, go outside. You see, I sleep to the park.
They tell me, go, okay, go. I have nowhere to go. I don't know nobody.
Sleep in the park. Sometimes you pick something from a refuge bin to eat. No house, nothing I can do.
Vraiment, en Grèce ici, on souffre beaucoup. On souffre. On souffre beaucoup. Alors vraiment, on a des difficultés même ici, même de se nourrir, payer l'eau, manger. C'est dur pour nous.
People, they have to help refugees in this country. They don't have arrangement for refugees. But we leave our country for problem. We don't leave our country as we like. Nobody like to leave his country for his heart. We live because of the problem.
They give me a gun, you know, AK-47, they say you have to fight.
Nordin did not want to fight. His mother sent him out of the country so he would be safe. From Syria, he walked for weeks, traveling through Turkey on foot to get to Europe.
I'm just solidarity.
Because usually immigrants come here and they don't have legal papers because they want to go to other European countries.
If you want to go to other country, France, Norway, airport problem. When we end up in a country very poor, you people should allow us to go.
Of course.
Where? In airport? Figure.
The other member states want Greece to control the border so that the people don't go irregularly there.
We are trapped in like a prison. It's a prison.
I go to the airport, I told them this paper they write, I have to leave the country within 30 days, so I'm leaving, I'm going to other country. I was arrested 3 days in jail.
There are many people and many asylum seekers that do not manage to apply for asylum and may be in the streets of Athens undocumented.
The police station in Athens, where most refugees make their initial asylum claim, is Petrourali. Applications can be made once a week.
I'm coming there 2 months every week I'm there.
And how long have you been here?
6 months.
2 years. Every week coming. No give paper.
Il y a des gens qui sont là 3 ans, 10 ans. On donne pas papier.
Yeah,
Thursday,
Friday, Saturday.
Day, night,
fall. Day, night. You see, the sun, the cold, no house, nowhere to sleep, no water, no food, no toilets.
Not only do asylum seekers queue day and night, sometimes waiting for months or even years to start their application, they also say the police forcibly disperse them, preventing them from registering their asylum claims.
Before you book him, they was pushing us like as a slave trade.
La police vient, on nous chasse, ou bien on s'en va. Après, on vient, ça va, on nous chasse.
Police beat.
They say we should go. People will stay here for quite long. They cannot pursue us again.
An interpreter was willing to speak about her experiences working at this police station on condition of anonymity. Her words are spoken by an actress.
I think one of the main problems with Petrourali is the back gate. In theory, your interview should take place from 3 up to 6 months after you applied for the asylum. Most of the cases it's not like that. It could be like 2 years before you have your first interview. So they have to come and renew their PIN card every 3 to 6 months. So they come at 6 o'clock in the morning, they wait outside behind the grills. Even if it's raining, if it's snowing, if it's 40 degrees, they have to wait there. So at 2:30 or 3, a couple or two come back and they call names without keeping any confidentiality at all.
Bilami, Afghanistan, Bilami, Allah Matula.
So they're given their PIN cards, but sometimes they also give rejections or positive, mostly rejections, because I've never heard of any positive decision actually. So they call names, they will bring in and out about 10 or 20 people. The point is they will not translate the whole decision, they will just tell them, you leave the country, you fuck off, or you're done with asylum, or you didn't convince anyone with your lies.
In these situations, extremist groups take advantage. They find fertile ground to take advantage.
The racist people, their community, which is called racist people, they don't like black people. They break the windows, you see.
Throwing the stone inside the house, and you're sleeping inside.
They were staying here like 10 minutes, and with the police also here.
They don't do nothing, you see. There are more than 50 people chanting,
go, but we can't do black people, something like that.
They stabbed one boy from here to here. The boy wanted to die. When I saw the boy yesterday, the boy started telling me that Christy Afgi wanted to kill him. Because they don't want foreigners. They call themselves Nazi group.
Christy Afgi, or Golden Dawn, is an extreme right party. In the 2012 elections, they won 18 out of 300 seats in the Greek parliament, with 7% of the vote. Mobile phone footage, published online, shows Golden Dawn supporters singing their anthem and giving Nazi salutes.
Staying in Achenon, that's on the street, I'm staying with my friends.
Achenon is a neighborhood in Athens with a large Somali community.
Welcome to Somalia, no Greek, Somalia.
Peace.
Yeah, this is the place, this is the house I'm living.
I sleep here, you see. But this is mine, I sleep here. There's other seven guys that sleep here. Not everybody has one. We share, you know, we share the meal.
10 people in this room.
18 people share this tiny one-bedroom flat.
We really need help from the European countries. Other, you know, we want to really get out of this country. We have really problem here.
I have eye problem in this eye, as you can see. I tried to go to hospital 3 times. They didn't help me nothing.
Nurdin managed to get a referral and prescription for his eye condition after visiting the free clinic run by Doctors of the World.
We started off by taking care only migrants and refugees patients. It's only the last 6 months when the economic crisis started that we see a lot of Greek patients as well. At least the last year we have a humanitarian crisis because of the economic crisis.
Since there's no money here, I understand here there's bad economic. You people should allow us to live.
C'est trop dur, quoi. En tout cas, je cherche l'opportunité de quitter la Grèce. En tout cas, que ce soit dans les pays européens, quoi.
And we see even asylum seekers now that they want to go back to their countries because they have no jobs. They cannot survive in Greece.
I'm maybe come back my country because here is not good for me. My country is better.
Really?
Yes.
Mahmoud has spent time in an Iranian prison.
Here is a situation where you feel that there is dire need for European solidarity and active